Brothers and sisters, great to talk to you. 28th of April, the month of April is moving very quickly. And even this morning we heard the great news about some restrictions being lifted so that we actually can catch up with a smaller number of people, but that's going to happen from the 1st of May. So that's good news. Long way to go still, but it's good to be able to be connecting again in this way. Lots of things are happening around the place. Thank you for your encouragement about our ministries and our sermons and our services. And again, great to hear a community story on Sunday. Can I encourage you to let us know what's happening around the place? Please contact Langdon, myself, Shane, the office, Adele at the office, with some stories about how you're traveling in this season. It just is a great encouragement to others as we continue to journey together through this season. Won't surprise you, the other day I was just thinking about again about what we're doing and where we're at, and I sort of wanted to hold this on for Mother's Day, but it just seems to be so appropriate today, so I wanted to share it with you. I was just thinking about the aspect of not knowing what's coming up tomorrow. That's one of our worlds now that we're living in. What's happening tomorrow? What's going on? And we're starting a new series on Sunday on James called Living Faith. And it wouldn't surprise you, there's a part of God's word in James chapter 4, verse 12. We read this verse 13. Now listen, you who would say today or tomorrow we will go to this city or that city, spend a year there, carry on business and make money. Why, you do not even know what will happen tomorrow. What is your life? Isn't that so true about our current situation? You are a mist that appears for a little while and then vanishes. Instead, we ought to say, if it is the Lord's will, we will live and do this or that. And it's just a great reminder. Again, you could read Ecclesiastes in that space as well about it's really hard to boast about what tomorrow will bring. And that took me to thinking about, again, old hymns that I'd heard about. And there's a lady called Mary Brainard. Again, she was a poet, a Christian poet, over 100 years ago. And she wrote a song called I Know Not What Awaits Me. I Know Not What Awaits Me. And you can check the lyrics out for yourself. I don't know too much about her life and about her journey, but in that song, it's really profound. The last verse of that hymn, it says this. So on I go, not knowing. I would rather not if I might. I'd rather walk in the dark with God than go alone in the light. I'd rather walk in faith with him than go alone by sight. And it stirred my heart, and it seems to be such a bold thing to sing about how you actually are happier to not know about tomorrow, but to walk by faith. And it's easy to say things like that, but we're all in this situation where we actually have to believe it and hold on to it. And it's just such a great and strong reminder of where our faith stands. And I love that. I'd rather walk in faith with him than go alone by sight. And so may I encourage you in this season, continue to trust in God, to walk with him, to sing and rejoice in God's goodness, which we'll again do on Sunday. A couple of things coming up. Again, can I remind you, the office is open Monday through to Thursday, 9 to 5. Continue to bring in those resources which have been really helpful for Anglicare. Non-perishable items and toiletries. We are continuing to bless our community through Anglicare in that way. Fantastic. Ladies, don't forget, register for the women's teaching night coming up this Thursday night at 7:30. You have to register by lunchtime on Thursday, so can I encourage you to do that as well. Again, a big shout out to all those who are connecting with us. Thank you that you're doing that. Thank you that you're encouraging us as we seek to encourage you as well. Finally, community stories, we really want to hear about what's going on. I've said that early in this video, but we really want to hear what's going on. And I want to give you a challenge. Okay, here's what I've just said to the staff we're going to do when we finally return. And so let's assume we're going to return in about 2 months, 3 months maybe. It's my view that when we actually have the green light to get together, we're going to have one service of celebration. So I want to get ready for that. And here's the challenge. I've just said to the staff, what the staff to sing two songs to our church as we gather. A worship song of praise to God and a secular song that would encourage you all. So here's the challenge. I want you to pass on to me what you think would be the most appropriate songs for the staff to sing to encourage you. We've got plenty of time to practice. And so please let us know that. Let us have a bit of fun too so that when we get to that point in time, we can also be encouraged as you too are encouraged. Brothers and sisters, take care. It's great to be able to talk to you this way. I look forward to catching up this week on Thursday, but indeed on Sunday.